All right, hit it.
We've got Casey McKinnon here with Galacticast. And Casey, glad to see you're here at South by Southwest.
Good to see you too, Paul.
And what have you been up to? When did you get here? What have you been doing?
I arrived on Thursday, and I've been trying to attend more film panels this year. I went to a lot of Interactive last year, and it was great because I got to meet all my friends from the internet. And but this year, I'm really trying to focus on my acting career, and so I wanted to go around and network with a lot more, you know, film people.
And has that been pretty successful so far?
Well, it's interesting because I feel kind of scared, you know, because when I'm in the Interactive section, I'm around people that I know and people who know me, and it's fun, and I feel really comfortable. But then when I go to the film, I really don't know anybody, and it's interesting. The only person I've really spoke to from the film section is Josh Brolin, because I saw him and I just wanted to talk to him, so I walked right up to him, and he's a really great actor, and I saw his directorial debut yesterday. He made a new movie called X. So I just went straight up to him and told him it was great. So
great. So yeah, you got to build those connections and relationships, don't you? And tell us about Galacticast, and then after that we're going to kind of get a look at the future and how you're what you're doing these days, but tell us how that got started and what that's all about.
Well, Galacticast got started by a labor of love between me and my boyfriend Rudy. We quote sci-fi all the time, and so it just became sort of natural for us to start a comedy show or a parody show for sci-fi. And so we did that. It's been, well, almost 2 years that we've been doing Galacticast. And it's great. Actually, we were just in a special effects panel, and they gave us a shout-out. Which is amazing because the people on the panel are people who've, you know, worked on the Star Wars movies and Sin City and all these wonderful, wonderful visual effects films. So it was really touching for them.
Yeah, that's interesting. So tell us about a couple of episodes and how you put them together and what's the content of the episode? Who writes them? Who does the camera work and who acts in them and all that?
Well, everything is done pretty much by me and my boyfriend, Rudy, and we started, one of my favorite episodes is called Robo Jew versus Giant Nazi Woman of the SS, and that one is really edgy, and we came up with that in a restaurant in Los Angeles. We were just sitting and thought of something funny and kept thinking of funny things, and basically that's how every episode starts, is my boyfriend and I come up with something funny and build on it, and usually he goes and writes the entire thing. We grab some friends and stick them in front of our green screen and then shoot. After that, I usually edit and do all the special effects, get my boyfriend to help with the special effects. But these days, he's going to be doing more editing and special effects so that I can focus on my acting career.
What kind of special effects do you use?
Well, we do a lot of layering. Most of it, because we work on green screen, we have to have a background. So, you know, we usually use Flickr and find some Creative Commons licensed photos to use in the backgrounds. But then, you know, we also have some fire effects and explosions and ships, 3D ships, stuff like that.
And sometimes you sort of satirize traditional media sci-fi, don't you?
Like what?
Like Battlestar Galactica?
Oh, yes. We actually have one of our proudest works was called Battlestar Galacticast, and that was a parody of the third season of Battlestar Galactica. And that was amazing because we actually made it with an independent filmmaker named Matt Campagna, who we're actually, we have cameos in his new movie called Six Reasons Why. But he is amazing, and he really, you know, he studied film, whereas we didn't. And everything we've learned is just by doing. In his case, he knows lighting, and he knows how to, you know, make the green screen work and make everything look real. So even people from Battlestar Galactica have seen that episode, and people have gone, oh my God, when were you on the set? We didn't see you. Because they're so confused. They couldn't believe that we actually had such clean backgrounds and that it looked so much like the show.
Well, have you watched that show?
Oh, absolutely. I'm a big fan.
What do you think of the concept, the show, and where it's going and all that? I guess they're going to have a few more episodes, aren't they?
Yeah, well, they're moving into their last season, and I'm really excited because they're not... I think they only have 20 episodes left, and every episode, I believe, is going to be directed towards the finale. Whereas in the last season, they've had some sidetracking episodes, character-building episodes, which I'm not as crazy about. So I'm really happy they're going to get back into the, like, pushing the story to the limits.
Who are your favorite actors in that series?
James Callis, Baltar. He is hilarious. He's amazing. Actually, I met him in Toronto, and he's a small man, but he's very handsome and very cool.
That's cool. So tell us about yourself and what you're looking at in your future in traditional media, and kind of talk about traditional media versus new media, however you want to characterize those buzzwords.
Well, there's really there's a big convergence between the two right now, and you know there's a lot of experimentation from traditional media to come over and you know make something online, see what all the buzz is about. I'd really like to work with people like that to launch a new show, and so currently I have some great ideas with my boyfriend Rudy. I'd like to star in something. We're working on something right now, and I can't go into great detail, but I really feel it's going to revolutionize online video because it's going to be like nothing you've ever seen before.
Oh, come on, go into detail.
I swear, and I can't go into detail because if I go into detail, someone else is going to take the idea first.
No, we can't have that.
Exactly.
And so, well, that's great. And so I hope these ideas prosper.
Me too.
Now tell me we mentioned Battlestar Galactica. What are some of your favorite sci-fi movies, TV shows, and sci-fi books? Or do you read books too about sci-fi?
I read all of the Dune novels, every single last one of them. And unfortunately, I can't read very often because I find myself in front of the computer all the time. So books are kind of archaic to me.
What about on the web? What do you like on the web as far as sci-fi and media and that kind of thing?
I don't really watch much. The stuff that I usually watch is YouTube videos.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and there's a lot out there, but I can't really pinpoint one to talk about. But in the traditional realm, I'm a huge fan of, well, Dune and Logan's Run, which I'm always telling...
Dune the book or Dune the movie?
Well, Dune the movie and the book. Everything, anything that has to do with Dune. And Logan's Run, which is one of my absolute favorite movies, the sexiest sci-fi movie ever made. And Planet of the Apes, the original with Charlton Heston. Yeah.
What about TV sci-fi?
TV sci-fi, well, Battlestar Galactica. I'm a huge Trekkie. I can't stand Star Wars because of George Lucas's special edition and the prequels. I'm anti-prequels.
Now, you guys are going to do a little band competition, I hear. What's that all about?
Well, we were asked, I was asked by Tim Shea from Next New Networks to start a band for a rock band party. And so it's happening Monday night. I grabbed Veronica Belmont, and I grabbed Leah Culver, who's from Pounce, and Bonnie Pierzina, who is from Noodle Scar Daily. I just thought, who would be the coolest chicks in a band with me? And so that's the band, and we are going to rock.
You're going to rock?
We are going to rock.
Now, what are you going to do in the band?
I'm the singer.
You're the singer.
Yeah.
What songs are you going to sing? Can you tell us?
Well, I'm trying to convince them to do Ballroom Blitz. I really love that song.
How does that go? Can you sing a few bars?
I cannot. You're just going to have to show up on Monday.
Well, just say a few bars then, okay?
Well, the man in the back said everyone attack, and it'll turn into a Ballroom Blitz.
And what other songs are you going to do, or is that it? Or is there more than one song you're going to do, like a whole set, or what?
Well, see, there's a bit of an age gap in the band. So I'm one of the older girls, so I know. Also, I have an older sister who's much older, so I kind of caught more 80s than the other girls did. So some of the younger girls want to do Weezer or, I can't remember, but more newer songs, more like late 90s.
Weezer,
yeah. I remember Weezer from the early 90s, but yeah, I like the 80s better.
So how many songs are you going to do all total?
Well, we might do 3 or 4.
All right. And who plays what and the other members?
We have Veronica Belmont on lead guitar, Leah Culver on bass, and Bonnie Pierzina on drums.
And have you guys practiced?
Yes, actually, Bonnie never played Rock Band before, and she decided she bought it, and she practiced like hell before she came here. So.
Now we're going to get to the part of the interview where I ask you just to randomly throw things out that are kind of on your mind, or what some of the conferences or things that you've been here brought to mind. So just kind of in rapid fire succession, just kind of throw out ideas that are kind of running through your head that are generated by South By now, if you don't mind.
Well, I was actually thinking yesterday about how there's a lot of documentaries in the film section, and I'm kind of disappointed because I love fiction. And I just find that there's a lot of very low-budget films here, right, because it's independent. And I really feel that they could be a little better produced. But documentaries are forgivable. So I find there's a lot of people who make documentaries because if the sound quality isn't very good, well, it's forgivable because it's a documentary. But if you're making fiction, it's more difficult because you're going to get, people are going to look at it and go, oh, the sound's not very good. Well, this sucks, you know. And it's kind of true in a way. You got to really focus on the audio, and it's a good thing you've got a microphone here. That's basically what I've been looking at, is seeing a lot of, you know, amateur works. And I'm actually really surprised because there's a lot of amazing content online that people are really pushing, high quality. And I think that there's a lot of stuff online that could easily be featured in the film festival. So I'd be interested to see more people submitting stuff from the online world next year.
What other random thoughts are running through your mind?
I just met Josh Brolin, and I feel a little giddy, because I really liked Grindhouse.
Yeah.
And so I actually went to see his movie yesterday. It's called X, and I saw him in the hall today, and I've been really shy when I go to film events because I don't really know anybody, but I saw his face and I felt like I knew him right away, so I was able to approach him really easily, and I'm still feeling a little I'm squealing inside a bit.
What other random things are running through your mind right now?
Well, there's a gentleman over there, you can't see him, but his name is Stu Mashwitz. He's one of the digital effects guys, he gave us a shout out in his panel, so it's really exciting.
That's pretty cool.
I'm showing that I'm a geeky fangirl.
That's okay. we're on the Geek News Central.
It's true.
So what else? Let's see. What's on your schedule for the next three? I guess we're on the hump day now. We're like the halfway through. So what's on your schedule?
Well, I actually have 2 minutes to get to an acting workshop.
Okay, well, we better let you go. But I do want you to toss out your destinations on the internet so people know where to find you and anything relevant like that.
Well, you can find me at caseymckinnon.com, and that's MCK, not MAC. and you can find all my links there. So,
and Galacticast?
Galacticast.com as well, exactly.
And how many other websites are there? There's quite a few.
Oh, there's quite a few. I think we own something like 25 website web URLs, so I won't go through them all. But if you go to my website, CaseyMcKinnon.com or Galacticast.com, you'll find links to everything.
And if they go to iTunes, they just have to type Galacticast, and that'll get your stuff, right?
Exactly.
It'll get it on their iPod.
It's true.
All right. Hey, it's been wonderful.
Thanks.
Enjoyed it, and have a great South by.
Thank you, Paul.
All
nice
right.
to meet you.
Nice to meet you.